Hey everyone, Lucas Kwiatkowski, founder of Nomadz, hands-on and advanced PPC. Now, I'll say it again, Q4 is coming, so if you guys want to reach out to us, we are here to audit accounts to get you set up for Q4 so you don't overspend. That is always our goal with our clients, is we make money when you make money. We're not in it for the short-term gain. All of our existing clients will know we work with them for years at a time because we're constantly adapting our strategy to make sure you stay competitive in the market. Not overspending, not underspending, working with you to reach your goals. So Q4 is coming, make sure you guys are prepared for it. Wanna do another scale insights video on a very, what seems like a simple metric that they have, but makes our life easier and makes analysis a lot easier. This is, so for all of you guys using scale insights who have been signed up with the affiliate link, I appreciate that. This is the main screen of Scale Insights when you come into it, right? For those of you who aren't using the tool yet. Now, if you click on sessions, so this will give you sales, units, all of this good stuff. And when you click on sessions, this is what we're looking for here, conversion percent. So it still blows my mind that Amazon doesn't have this in Seller Central. So you have to go to business reports, and then you have to kind of work backwards and say, okay, you have to manually calculate your PPC conversion rate. This is total conversion rate, okay? So this isn't PPC or organic. This is total conversion rate for the product. It gives you sessions, conversions, and PPC clicks. Now, we can see these here, and you guys are gonna see, I might dive into this in another video. You see, like, oh, well, why are you dipping so much on these days? 23rd, 24th, 30, 31, 6, 7, day parting. So for a lot of our bigger clients, we've had a lot of times where we see a clear pattern of drop in conversion rate on days of the week, we will lower spend on those days. So that's why I believe these are Saturday and Sunday. So these are Saturday and Sunday. This product does not convert on the weekends. A lot of people don't, but a lot of people convert even better on the weekends. So you need to watch this. This is the stuff that we're always looking out for. So what we do, say, okay, we're converting at 15% on weekdays, and then some weekends we're converting 10 to 11%. So why would we wanna spend more on those days when we're not converting? We wanna save our ad spend for when it's working well. So just right off the bat, just having this in a graph on Scale Insights as compared to Seller Central makes that, like, this is just clear as day that we can see conversion rate is dropping on certain days of the week. And it's like Sunday especially is not good. So boom, we're able to go in there, put in an automated rule of lowering budgets on those days of the week and then ramping back up again on Monday. And it helps us so much. Okay, so this is the main graph, but also going one step further, when you scroll down here, you can go to any product and you scroll over and you go to the historical sales performance. So you come out of the product and you can see, again, you're gonna go to sessions and look at this, sales by date. Now, and I know this seems so simple, but this is why we love this tool, days of the week. So even if you're seeing dates and like doesn't quite click for you, you can go to ASIN level data, look at days of the week and say, okay, this product, let me just see here. So I'm not sure they have conversion rate exactly on this screen. One second. It's right here. So conversion. So this is for one ASIN and it's showing us. So let's look at some Sunday, Saturday, okay? Sunday, 10%. Sunday, 11%. Monday, 15%. That's a huge jump in conversion rate, okay? And so look at this, how we're parting this. So on Saturday and Sunday, we're spending about 150, 170 on ads, right? And then 500, 600 a day during the week because we're converting better, right? So I don't want to say day parting is for everybody because everyone is going to go and watch this video and say, oh, okay, I'm going to slash my budgets on the weekend or I'm going to slash my budgets on a certain day of the week. There needs to be a very clear difference in conversion rate. Don't look at ACOS because cost per clicks can change. Don't look at ACOS. Look at conversion rate, but also you need to be able to organize this correctly. So if you do day parting incorrectly and you try to do it manually and you forget, it's really going to hurt you. So you need to have a tool like this that's set up properly where a team like ours that is watching it, we can say, okay, we're not going to come into an account and do day parting immediately. We're going to take a couple of months, take a few months and see, okay, this product is healthy, but now we're in phase 4 of this product where we're constantly making, trying to get marginal gains. That's when we do day parting, right? And we do it smartly. We know the ups and downs that we're doing to ramp that up. So if you're using Scale Insights, the takeaway from this video is look at conversion rates by date. And if you're interested about day parting, I will make another video about that so you guys can dip your toes in it. Don't go crazy right away with it. Do it slowly and smartly, and it'll help you make those marginal gains for Q4.